Hello there, everyone, and we're back once again with more Touhou Puppet Play Enhanced version 1.01. Now then, concerning something new that I did take in consideration everybody's choices, and, well, here's my final team. I was actually able to kick out Momiji because I figured out something Aya could do. Learn Cut. Of course, this kind of sort of makes her my HM slave for this whole dealio, so, yeah. Anyway, so, today our team is Chibi Cirno, Chibi Satori, Letty, Suika, Aya, and Sanae. Anyway, so, well, it's time to hit the gym because there's not much left to do in this town. We gotta take care of that. Especially if we're gonna hit the Elite Four anytime soon. Oh wait, hang on. We gotta talk to the pervy old man hanging outside the gym. This gym is great, it's full of women! Oh, jeez. There's gotta be a pervy old guy in every anime trope type thing, doesn't there? I think I should try to actively dodge as many of them as... Really? See, look, look, see my Boneka. I like the grass type. I like how they're so easy to raise. Really? I've actually found them quite difficult to raise. Especially with nothing to train them on, really. Sweet, merciful Lord Cirno's defense is low. Let's use Letty instead. It's only special defense that Cirno sucks with, but it's just enough that it counts. Oi. One hit knockout like I expected. Yes! Well, no wonder that pervy old guy's looking in there. They're all dressed pretty scantily from the looks of that chick. Yeah, Cirno's not as good as Letty so far. I wonder if that'll hold true through the rest of the whole thing. Probably, given that it's Cirno, but, and that she was the mid-boss to Letty's, stage one boss. Of course, that's not saying a whole lot now. Okay, I'm gonna switch out for Aya. Not gonna bring out Suika for this gym, because, the unfortunate side effect of being Earth-type is that you're weak to nature. Kaguya. Nothing new here, so I'll just skip to her being kicked down. That took relatively little effort. I took a hit, but it's not that bad. And finally, let's take on the head cheese. Flower arranging grass. Yes, of course I wish to challenge you. Why else would I be here, lady? I beg to differ. I think you will lose. Especially since I have three that can take you on. Yuka. She's a bit new here, isn't she? I'd imagine her to be physically heavy, but not have a lot of special power. And, apparently she has very little defense, too. A full-grown Shizuha, as opposed to a teeny-tiny one, and, well, Aya's got speed boost, so she'll go a little faster every time. You can't put to sleep what isn't there, silly girl. But this is gonna suck. Or not. Jeez, I'm getting really lucky this time. Huh. That was quick. All things considered. Aya grew to level 29! Aya's actually pretty good. Considering some of the others I've come across. Minoriko, leave it to Cirno! Oh, wait, what am I doing? She's got 26 HP, and I'm sure Minoriko is, special-based. Ice Punch or Aura Beam. We'll go with Ice Punch. Cirno seems to be a touch better in the physical department. And of course, there's that, and that's going to kill her. But don't worry, she's a fairy, so she'll come back at some point in time. And of course, Letty will come to her aid and quickly dispose of this trash, as long as its defense is low enough. I might be in a sticky spot here, especially if potions start coming through. Yeah, it all really depends. Yep, here comes a potion. Yeah, I thought as much. Hyper potion, how much HP does she have? I mean, level 33, but still. Oh, that was pretty lucky. Probably not gonna keep up, though, given my luck. You're paralyzed, you can't move. What you gonna do? Oh, I should've used rest. Not that it would've mattered. Aya! Help! What am I saying? Methinks I should've used some strategy first. Because, yeah. I'm under the assumption she has another potion, so I'm gonna cherry up. Cherry fruit, there you are. That's what I thought, okay. Oh yeah, I'm using some strategy. Okay, sorry. Aya's getting faster and faster and faster. So I'm gonna sand attack, of course. I want the enemy to have as little luck with that stun spore as possible. I'm gonna try it again, just to be sure. Because I really don't want stun spore to hit a second time. Okay, wing attack. Let's start going on the offense now. It flinched, yes! She flinched, I should say. Come on, flinch again. No! Why did you hit? Well, I'm not gonna be using fly on the off chance that, well, she comes down and, she's hit by paralysis. Even paralyzed, she's still faster. That's nuts. That didn't hurt. Well, I guess I'm not in such a tough spot after all, because, gym's over. That worked quick. And Aya may become the highest level member of our team here. Down with Erika! Up to level 50, that's for trading only. Ooh, TM19, what are you? Giga Drain? If I would have. If it's correct anyway, I just gotta check. Yes, you are, and you do a lot more damage than you used to. At least for the original games. In Black and White, you do 5 more damage, I think, but that's fine. Yeah, sorry about that speed up, but I really don't like going so slow. Indoors. And with that, we are pretty much done in Celadon. However, there's still one more thing to take care of. Hello there, dude. What are you doing blocking this path? I scalded my tongue. This nice lady in the mansion gave me some tea. But it was boiling hot. I gotta cool it to drink it. Some tea, huh? I could maybe use that somewhere. Not on myself, of course, because I hate tea. Not just me, though. I'm a silly little American who has no taste for bitter stuff. You're not an eater, Anne. Whatever. Alright, I might want to hit the Boneka Center. I wanted to say Pokemon, but this is clearly not Pokemon anymore, even though it's the same locations. Our team is restored and ready to go. So, we have the Sylph scope now, if I'm not mistaken, so I figure it's probably best to go straight for, well, straight for Lavender again, because we need to go there. But let's cut through Saffron to do it. Oh, that tea, it looks awfully tasty. Huh? I can have this drink? Gee, thanks! Glug, glug. If you want to go to Saffron City, you can go on through. I'll share this tea with the other guards. Mmm, yum. Yes, I'm sure they'd like your backwash. Okay, so then let's move on. Back through here. Man, there's a lot of rockets in town. That's not what's important right now. What's important is that we go to Lavender and take care of some unfinished business in a tower somewhere. Skippy, 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 skippy. Skippy all the trainers. Okay then, we're back in Lavender. And our team is all full up on health and everything, so I think we're good to go. Not sure how great an idea it is to put Cirno at point on the off chance special attacks may occur, but whatever. It died because it doesn't exist. And you've come to terms with that. Oh, hello there, rival. Didn't see you there. No, it's not dead. Okay, battle number, four, I think. Chibi Medicine versus Chibi Cirno. Well, with any luck, this will go off without a hitch. At least I'm around even level with the rival instead of being grossly over-leveled. Oh, that's going to hurt. Ow, that hurt. And now she's poisoned, too. Cirno certainly is really easy to knock down, isn't she? That's kind of annoying. I mean, yeah, she's faster than Letty, but that does get old. Pichuu. No, I don't think so. Let's pull out Suica. Because chances are she can't handle well with physical power. Rock slide. That magic coat won't do you a whole lot of good. And fire punch. Because I can. Well, that was nice and easy. Yeah, Suica's pretty tough against special attacks, too. She's just the kind for cases like Patchouli. And Nitori, which will lead me to pull out. Why not? Satori. Just to get the whole choice cast out. Now, Satori still only has Mirror Shot and Recollection. I really don't recommend using Recollection all that much because, it doesn't prove too helpful to use an opponent's own moves against them, especially if they're all the same type as the opponent. Or if they could just turn around and use the same strategy against you. Could be nice if you use it right, but other than that, I can't really see a good reason for it. Shanghai. Believe that one's new. What do I want to throw out? What do I want to throw out? Suica, probably. And there's Shanghai. One of Alice's many dolls. Just one. And even then, it's only a certain kind of the dolls, too. Ouch, that's gotta hurt. A little. But what's with the low level on it? That's kind of silly, is all. I think I'm gonna keep Suica out for that, because, Alice likes to use a lot of special moves. And Suica was specifically designed to fight special types. So, yeah, she's pretty tough. And Alice can't hit us with her doll wall because, well, Rock Slide doesn't touch. Crap. Crud. And, let's use a super potion that we never use. Slight beam. Slightly annoying. Ow. Okay, we'll try one attack. You're confused and Rock Slide, yay! Okay, gotta heal you again because don't wanna risk you knocking yourself out and well, you punch pretty hard. Jeez, what is with you getting critical hits every time I use a healing item? Hit itself in its confusion. And you're gonna get a critical hit, aren't you? Oh, well, that was pretty lucky. Whew. Okay, let's use one of our many, many fresh waters. I only have two of those on accident. Trying to get a bunch of lemonades. I like to stock up quite a bit, and that used up a lot of my money, which I could have used instead on the... Good lord, snap out of it! I'm getting sick of confusion. Good thing I brought so many healing crap. Oi. You know, this is also a standard RPG strategy, too, is to... Heal, attack, heal, attack, heal, attack. While not letting the enemy do the same. Because the enemy is unable to or something. And that takes care of my rival Akumu. You stinker, really? What are you, Bugs Bunny? How did you catch a Cubone? They don't exist. Well, back to the Boneka Center. Okay, that's better. Now our team is healed up and ready to go! It just kinda seems like some members of my team are more useful than others. I mean, yeah, Cirno is pretty balanced with attack and defense, and, well, attack and special attack, but she doesn't really do well against special attacks. And I like using special attacks a lot, and I'm sure other people do too. And this game certainly likes to. Channeler Hope send out Lunasa. Huh, I get the feeling that we're gonna see a whole bunch of Prism Rivers in here. I don't know why, I just get the feeling. You learn Toxic Gas? Right, that's right. Well, that's going to get very annoying. See how much better you do against Ice Punch. Far worse! Well, looks like I'm gonna be using Ice Punch throughout most of this. Escape rope! Just in case I wanted to run away like a sissy chicken wuss. Okay, so then, let's try not to fight all of the channelers. Oh, and, some of our, ooh! Erika? Yes, please! Let's see here. Pardon me, this'll take a moment. Hurrah! I caught her! The keyboard player of the Prism River Sisters band produces the Fantasia song. So now we're starting to fill up Box 2 with a full team. That's something. Now, I'm gonna start using repels from now on whenever I hit areas with wild Boneka because, I can come back to them on my own time. And to be quite honest, I probably don't want to bore people if I can help it. Can I avoid you? Yes, I can. Can I get you? Yes, I can. Elixir. slightly more useful than the ether, but still not going to use a lot of these. An awakening. Let's see here, how can I maze my way through this so I don't get noticed? Relatively easily, from the looks of things. A normal orb, I could use another one of those out of my 40. Yeah, I overpack. Just sneaking around the whole lot of you. Ooh, a purification spot, huh? A cleanse tag, which will lower encounter rate and is very nice overall. Oh, what do you got? Zombies! How random. And Lunasa. Man, they were just punching each other's faces in! Cirno won out though because Lunasa was stupid enough to use physical attacks on Cirno. And that takes care of that. Cirno's evolving. Well, this is definitely a step up. So now Chibi Cirno will turn into, well, normal Cirno. Not entirely surprised here. Now she's taller than everyone. Nah, she's probably not that much taller. Okay then, so I want that item, I want that item. It's a nugget. Nugget of what? I don't know. A nugget of chicken, a nugget of poo, a nugget of, X accuracy! Aw, man! Can't sneak around every one of them. What are you, a bat? Well, you are a crazy bat, that's for sure. I don't know how old you are, but whatever. Oh, you're just gonna cream her, aren't you? Wow, froze her with one punch and then gonna finish her with the other. Yeah, that's creaming, alright. Okay then, yeah, Cirno's just gonna steamroll some through these chibis, isn't she? Ow! Did you barf on me or something? That's mildly unpleasant. Lyrica! We just caught you, so, I really don't know what's up with you. Come to think of it. And we're probably not going to be able to see because Cirno's going to punch you out. Punch your lights out relatively quick. Huh, maybe I am slightly overleveled again. I won't be leveling up any higher than I am now. Repel's effect wore off. Well, we can't have that. Gotta spray ourselves over again. With anti-doll spray. And a rare candy, which we'll never use. And it's time to face the mother. Or something. The ghost appeared. Silphscope unveiled the ghost's identity. Layla? What's Layla? Another prism river that I'm not aware of? Oh, yeah, well, duh. It would only make sense. Psycho boost, really? Well, Cirno's dead. Ouch. You're a ghost, so I'm not entirely certain what to throw against you, Suika. Icy wind. Ow. Well, you deal pretty well with ice, actually. That's nice to know. I'm just gonna keep on using this attack. And you're gonna keep on using Psycho Boost, which will get exponentially weaker every time you use it. That's right, I remember you a bit more now. You're the original Prism River, and, well, created the other three somehow or another. Right? I think I'm right. Explains all the instruments behind her. Ha, Parish Song. You're not going to do anything with that move. Because I'm gonna hit your lights out before it even ends. Well, I probably shouldn't use Karate Chop to do it. Well, either way, you win this fight as long as you can tank it, right? Oh, and then Psych Up to, restore yourself so you can use Psycho Boost again. Genius! Now, what would happen if I, lowered my own? The ghost was the restless spirit of Cubone's mother! No, it wasn't. Departed to the afterlife. Well, that's certainly nice. Cirno, no! Quick, I gotta unmelt you. Let's see, what do we got? Well, I'm gonna, give Suika lemonade, even though that's not what she wants. And, where's our revives? Man, I need to reorganize this thing. Do we even have a revive? There it is. No, I don't want to use it on Suika. Jeez. There we go, that's better. And then, lemonade. And we're all good again. Okay then, now to the top floor of the Boneka Tower. Rockets again? Do they ever quit? No, I don't think they do. Chibi Rumia! We've seen you. And, Rumia gets outdone by Cirno. Not entirely certain if that's anything new. Cirno takes out Momiji? That definitely is something new. And, Chibi Rumia. Wow, critical hit with Aurora Beam. That'll take care of you. Yeah, you better give up. It's freaking Cirno now. I'm not gonna forget this. Not that I'm gonna do anything about it. Let's swap out to Satori because, I get the feeling she's going to be pretty nice against all these Rumia. Just saying.
This old guy marched right up to our hideout. Then he starts ranting about how Team Rocket's abusing Boneka. So we're just talking it over as adults.
Yeah, sure you are. That's why you threw him at the very top of this tower and kept him here, huh? Chibi Wriggle versus Chibi Satori. Let's see how this goes. Or not, because I'm going to cut it out. Well, Satori won. Okay, another Wriggle.
Wriggle, kicking people in the face isn't nice.
Okay, sorry about that. Yeah, Satori went down on the second one. Go figure.
Please, no more!
Well, quit throwing bugs at me. Letty's evolving too? Yeah, and level 28 is like the mile marker for a lot of these, isn't it? Now, Chibi Letty is... Normal Letty! Not entirely surprised by that, actually. And she's not fat. Look at that sprite.
Boneka are only good for making money. Why not use them? You stay out of our business.
Okay, so now she's evolved, so let's see how different she is. Very good in special territory. Kinda looks like... Cirno would be better if her special defense wasn't so low. Everybody's gotta have a weakness, though, right?
You're not saving anyone, kid!
Yeah, I'm sure I'm not. Chibi Rumia. How about that body slam hurt? Chibi Chan. Nothing new. That Aurora Beam did it. Chibi Chan. Still nothing new. Do you have anything new on you, guy? Well, that was just as easy as the last one. And Chibi Rumia. Ah, why not? It's the last battle of this recording, so... Body Slam. Gotta keep a physical move on Letty somehow. And level up to level 29. And that takes care of our Rocket Grunt. Why shouldn't I mess with you? You were relatively easy to take down. Yes, I came to save you, Mr. Fuji. You came here of your own free will. Now to call him Cubone's mother. What's a Cubone and what's a Marowak? Yes, it is. The Poke Flute! Boneka Flute. Excuse us. Upon hearing the Poke Flute, sleeping Boneka will spring awake. Try using it on Boneka that are sleeping obstacles. I definitely will! Next time! So, well, see you then, everybody.